My name is Sylvester Onyemalechi. You're welcome to Sound Mind for Positive Life. Today I want to talk to you on the need for preparation in order to have a changed life. Anything you don't prepare for, you don't succeed in it. Today I want to let you know that you need to prepare to gain new life. You need to prepare to live a transformed life by dropping the old. So we talk about getting rid of the old in order to embrace the new. Getting rid of the old in order to embrace the new. Now, wisdom teaches that a biased mind will not allow you to see the good in a thing. So if my mind is biased, if I already have a preconceived notion about a thing, no matter what you try to show me, no matter the painstaking effort you will put in to try to point me to the right direction or explain the truth to me, it's going to be difficult for me to accept it. So the best way is to set aside what you know, what you have believed. Get rid of the old in order to have the new. Jesus said you cannot take a new wine and put it into an old wineskin. Otherwise, the old wineskin cannot hold it. And the new one is too strong for the old wineskin, so it will burst and waste. Then I want to read a scripture for you. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 1 to 3. This is what Peter, the apostle, said. So therefore, rid yourselves of all malice and all deceit, hypocrisy, envy, and slander of every kind. Like newborn babes, crave pure spiritual milk, so that by it you may grow up in your salvation. Now that you have tasted that the Lord is good. So before you can start drinking the milk, before you can start accepting the new, so that your growth can begin, he said you need to first of all get rid of this. Get rid of all this old stuff. Get rid of the old lifestyle. Make up your mind that you're dropping them. They are not going to get in the way. The malice, the deceit, the hypocrisy, the envy, the slander, get rid. In other words, I need to get rid of the old to embrace the new. And when you are holding on to the old, you cannot embrace the new. If you are holding something in your hands and I'm bringing a new gift, beautiful gift to give to you, you cannot collect it with those things in your hands. You will first of all drop what you are holding in your hands and then you can accept the new gift from me. That's the way it works. And so there is every need for us to drop the old mindset. Stop believing all those lies that you used to believe. It was those things that made you live the way you live. Every man lives based on the knowledge base that he has. We all act based on our beliefs. We all talk based on our beliefs. We all relate, we all judge based on our beliefs. And so if your beliefs are wrong, then you've got a problem. Your life will be wrongly lived. Your experiences will also be wrong. Jesus said, if the light in you is darkness, how great is that darkness? So if what you thought was the right principle is actually a wrong principle of life, what you thought was the truth was actually a lie, what you thought was the way of God was actually not the way of God but the way of man, it's a twisted knowledge, then your life will also be twisted. And so that is the reason why when we come to Christ, Romans chapter 12 verse 2 says we need to be transformed through the renewing of our minds. But the first step to that is, first of all, do not be conformed any longer to the pattern of this world. You must agree, I belong to a new kingdom, I don't belong to the old kingdom. And so the old way of reasoning, the old way of looking at life must be changed. So you must drop that to take on the new. And so you need to relearn about life. get into the Word of God. So if you're watching me and listening to me and you're the type that doesn't like the Word of God, you need to change. You're the type that doesn't read the Word of God, you need to change. You need to start reading the Bible. You're the type that when they start preaching, you become uncomfortable. You start to go out, you go out to ease yourself. You look at something, you start reading something else. You start checking your phone. You never pay attention. You never concentrate. Or you're the type after you have listening, you choose the word to believe and you throw away the rest. You are cheating yourself. You've got to get rid of the old to accept the new. Never learn about a thing with a preconceived notion or belief about that thing. Always empty out the former for you to see well. You cannot learn about a thing holding on to a preconceived notion. Whatever notions you had, whatever belief system you have, got to drop it. Before I came to the level of knowledge that I am today, I was a Catholic. I was trained in the doctrines of the Catholic Church. And there are so many things they taught that I believe, and I believe them. But when I came to Christ and I came into the charismatic circles and I began to study the Bible, there were a lot of conflicts. So I was finding it difficult to accept these things. I was finding it difficult to accept the new truth. And God had to come to my aid. In fact, I went from conference to conference, arguing about the rosary, arguing about many things that I have believed and I've lived all my life. And it got to a point where the Lord had to tell me the truth. And what is that? He said, drop all those things you have believed and I will teach you. And I agreed with him. From that day, my life changed. The scriptures just popped open. Insight started coming. The word of God came alive and became my delight. I no longer argue with it. I just accept it as God says. I no longer read the Bible through the eyes of the Catholic, or through the eyes of the Catholic Church, or as a Catholic. But I read the Bible as a child of God. And the word of God comes alive. And I'm blessed. And I'm able to bless you today. So drop the old. Whatever it is your fathers taught you, whatever it is your tradition taught you, whatever it is your former religion taught you, whatever it is Buddha taught you, whatever it is you learned from whatever religion that you practiced before now, throw them away. Open up. Let God re-educate you. Whatever your belief is as far as relationship is concerned, as far as sex is concerned, as far as marriage is concerned, various subjects and areas of life is concerned, throw them aside. Put them aside. Let God re-educate you. When you do this, your life will change. Things will get better for you. So I want you to know that mental preparation for any venture is more important than financial or material preparation. Please, prepare your mind always in whatever you want to do. You want to get married, prepare. You want to start a business, prepare. You want to grow in Christ, prepare. You want to grow in knowledge, prepare. You want to live a successful Christian life, prepare. Whatever you want to do, mental preparation, get your mind ready. Educate yourself. Get into the Word. Educate yourself. Read. Listen to others who have learned it, who have been there before you, people who have experienced. Meditate. Analyze. Come to conclusion. So get yourself ready so you can succeed. So you can face the challenges that will confront you tomorrow. God bless you. Throw away the old and accept the new. That's what the word repent means. Change your mind. Anytime you discover the truth of God's Word, change your mind. The Lord bless you. Amen.